Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BUVU Gaming, and today we are back in Beetle Uprising. So, they are... Let's just see. Next, inventory, there we go. Let's give you guys some more food. They seem to always complain about that. They're playing a little bit with that little play rack. And you are gonna go and eat. Awesome. Well, I think we kind of need to head out and explore. So how did we do that? Map. Okay, welcome to the map. The map shows all the areas around the nest that must be conquered. This is the nest area in the bottom right corner of the map. By exploring areas and completing missions, you can conquer the whole map. The icons on the map show activities your beetles can do to advance the swarm's goals. Some activities let you explore an area which either discovers the area itself or finds new activities in that area. Some activities send a beetle to forage for food or scavenge for useful items. Pick an item to show that activity or narrate. Tasks and missions for the selected area show up here. You can select a task on the map or from this list and then choose which beetle you want to undertake it. When you tell the beetle to begin the task, it will leave your nest and either gather items or explore the map for you. It's a dangerous world out there, so there is a chance that the beetle will be injured or even die while on a task. This is a combat mission. There are stragglers around our nest left over from the Matriarch's great struggle. We must eliminate them to proceed. Click the attack button on the right to create your swarm and battle the enemy. This is an exploration task. These tasks discover other activities in the same area. Okay, so I can't go to these areas yet, it seems. What does this one do? Foraging task. Bring food back. That is important. We need more food, actually. So, let's see. Currently deployed, none. The remaining times this activity can be completed, so I can't do this anymore? Huh? Thing. Okay, not welcome. Opens and closes. Explore around the nest. Okay. Forgiven harvest. Aha, that is the one. Possible rewards. Food. The remains of the fallen from the Matriarch's sacrifice need harvesting. Chance of death, 0. Chance of injury, 0. Chance of success, 100%. Armor and strength affect injury and death chances, whereas perception, ferocity and happiness affect success chances when foraging. Okay, so P, F and H would be what we would like. So let's just see, do we have anyone who's good at that? It looks like Takiki would be the best one. You're kind of red in P, red in F, red in A. What is it? P, F, and happiness. H. Okay, you are yellow in yellow. You're red in H. Well, you're kind of yellow in yellow. Yellow in all of them. You would probably be the best one. How do I? There we go. Takiki. I think we're gonna try and send you out, right? What was it? Yellow was good and red was bad, right? If I remember correctly. So let's just see. Foraging tasks. Click here to start this activity. Foraging tasks gather food for the nest. The selected beetle will leave the nest for the duration of the task and will return when done. If this button is disabled, either the task can no longer be attempted or the selected beetle is not heavy enough to go. Okay. Armor and strength affect injury and death. Perception, ferocity and happiness affect chance. Yep. Okay. This activity is in a hostile environment, which increases the chance of injury or death. Complete the mission in this area to conquer the area to make the area friendly. Okay, well, it says here that there's no risk to lose anyone, so that should be good. It is a kind of a beginning area. This beetle is on a task. The Kiki will be out of the nest for 1 minute, 1 hour. and will then report the status of their task. Well, let's just get that so we can find ourselves what is going on. Okay, so let's see. Can I see that? Yeah, okay, so you have kind of this red here, and right now, of course, we are paused. What if I say this? Okay, so it's 1 minute. Let's just pause for now. Then we have well rested. Okay, what kind are you? Well, that's a scavenging task, which finds useful items for the nest. Okay, let's check. Possible rewards, something for the bed, something for the grooming, and a toy item. Okay, this place might not provide the best, but it will give you some rest. Okay, no risk to die, for anyone to die. Oh, I actually forgot to check the success chance on the previous one when we changed the beetles around. But I would expect that this would be the same things we would like for this one. So maybe we should wait until Tagiki comes back. Let's see, you have a red P, you had a red P, you have a red F, and maybe Nesna. No, that actually gets worse. HP and F was... HP... Okay, so is P the... Is the red one a good one? Red is a bad one, so why is Uzi better for that than Nesna? I don't get it. Because H and P is better for Nesna, and F is the same, so I would have thought that Nesna would be better for this. That's interesting. What if we try some of the others? That's 81. Okay, H is down. P, you don't even have anything. Okay, this doesn't make much sense to me. Okay. Strength. And quickness. And regeneration. And then we have armor, of course. Okay, unicorn. Quill. Okay, 87. 81, 71, 78. Okay, so you are actually the best one. That's interesting. Because you have a red one, but you also have a... Okay, I don't get it, but at least it tells me here, chance of success. Okay, well, let's send you out on that one then. Yep, that's fine. And what else do we have? Explore around the nest. This old nest is a good start. Scout the area for more resources. When a beetle attempts an exploration task, it might discover additional sources of food and items. Okay. No risk of anyone dying. Heroes is actually 88%. I would still think that would be... Yeah, I guess some of them still requires armor and strength, some of these. Probably the case. Okay, well, I'm gonna have to learn that over time. But you are 88%. What are you? 85%. And you are 70%. Okay, Deepers. Do I have anyone else? I don't think so. No. Because we don't have that many yet. Okay, well, let's send you out on this one. Ah, okay, that's fine. Not welcome. We might need more people or more beetles for this though. Possible rewards. Okay, eggs. Ooh, new genetics. That would be nice. And food and other nice items. Okay, a starting beetle. It has the basics to get the job done, but is particularly lacking in armor. A handful of stragglers from the forces defeated by the matriarch are wandering about our foot doorstep. Roll over them with the unwelcome mat. Chance of death on failure, 0%. Okay. The number of stars on an objective indicates its ranking within the mission. The single star objective is the easiest to complete and lowest rank. The three stars objective is the hardest to complete and gains you the highest ranking on the mission. During a mission, a star that is gray hasn't been completed. A star that is gold indicates those objectives have been completed, and a star that is crossed out indicates that the objectives can no longer be completed. Aha, okay, kill all the wandering enemies. Complete all one-star objectives. Aha. What are all of them? Isn't that just one of them? Finish in less than 3 minutes. Okay, complete all two-star objectives. Finish in less than 1.5 minutes. Okay. Well, I don't really have a lot of people to send off to do this. We have Nesna and Udzi. I would probably need more than that. But if I said check. Create your swarms, not welcome. Does it tell me anything about chance of death and failure? But it doesn't tell me what the chance is to survive, does it? What is all of this? Attack type summary. Okay, extra damage against... Ooh, okay. Attack type bite does basic physical damage to an adjacent enemy. Strength powers it and armor blocks it. Attack type bile spit does physical damage at a short range to a single enemy. Strength powers it and armor blocks it. Okay, so you have bite or what? If I say Uzi, so do you. What is this down here? Ah, units 18, right, because you make a copy of this one. You have strength and attack, actually. Uzi would be the best one to use for this. Why are you more expensive than this one? Because you're not as happy or what? U, H, and P. Okay, Uzi has two red ones though, that's true. Superior or inferior stat relative to the rest of your collection. I would have thought you would be better because you have a higher stat in attack and in strength. But of course your regeneration and your perception. Perception allows beetles to see further and notice things more easily. Regeneration allows the beetle to heal when it takes damage and helps on scavenging tasks. I have to start learning more of these. Aha, quickness helps on exploration tasks. Okay, this probably explains the results I got before. We'll have to look into that some more. But the more expensive, then I would suspect that this one would be better. Because it's more expensive to send up. This swarm will fight under the white banner. Okay. So I can only use one beetle to send something out. Okay, then I can choose how many units send out, and that will cost me 100. How much goop do I have? So I have 1700, that should be okay. But this one doesn't, it doesn't show us anything about the chance, so, well. After you set up the swarm, she'll use the fight. Well, it doesn't seem like I can choose more than one beetle. I thought I could choose like a combination of them, but it doesn't really seem like it. If I say Uzi now, that will also show 25, yeah. Okay, well, we're gonna just try with you. Okay. Let's just see what happens. I have no idea. Whew. Okay. This is your swarm of beetles to control. Click on the ground to set the marker where you want your swarm to go. Move your swarm forward now. Okay. Ah, so that's my marker. Can I scroll out? I can see you. Oh, use the mouse wheel to zoom the camera in and out, or the Q and E keys. Try it now and then move your beetles forward a bit more. Yep. Well, oh, To move the camera, use the WASD keys. Double tap the one key to make the camera follow your swarm. Okay. Well, right now. Okay, that is the max I can scroll out. I wonder what is over there. Okay, I can't go in there. I wanted to see if I could spot anything that we find. So far I'm not seeing anything, but it's probably because it's still a little bit tutorial-like. Okay, let's try and go over here. Your beetles will automatically attack when they are close to enemies. Hold the shift key when you click on the ground, or double-click to tell your swarm to ignore enemies while marching to the marker. Go find some enemies. Hold the shift click. Okay. Or double-click. The objectives for the mission are here in the upper left. To complete this mission, you must eliminate all the straggling enemies that are wandering around. Completing more than the first objective, you will get better rewards. Okay. There we go. Nice. Then they'll go back to the marker. Can I do anything? Okay, let's go. So if I do this, double click, then they'll ignore them and go to the marker. And then they'll kill anything that comes close. Okay. Click over there, go to the marker, and attack. Then they attack as a group, so I'm thinking that's a good thing. Okay, take you out. Here. Oh, what was that sound? No idea. Okay. Someone coming there. Take you out. Over here. Down this one. Nice. Is out. Down you. Oh, someone is sitting at us. Over here. Oh, I go up there. See if we can chase down these tracklers. Nice, okay. Complete. Finish in less than 3 minutes. Nice, we are victorious. We will keep what is ours. Destiny awaits. Nesta is not very happy now. Our nest, 2 or 3 star, a starting beetle. It has the basics to get the job done. Oh, look at all these fireworks. But it's particularly lacking in armor. Yes, yes, yes. Okay. Well, we did do this one. I don't know how you're supposed to get this. Oh, right. We have to do it even faster. But that's okay. We have learned about the number of swarms. We have learned what types of enemies there are. We have learned how many enemies oppose us. I think I must have messed up somehow, because I feel like I should have had been able to send out more than one swarm, maybe, so I can use more than one beetle at a time or something. Because otherwise it's kind of hard if you have to chase down all of these. But yeah, maybe that's only supposed to be one swarm. I don't know. I have no idea. So, let's see. A starting beetle, our nest 1 star. Our nest 2 or 3 star, a starting beetle. It has the basics to get the job done, but it's particularly... Okay. This one has a bit of armor, but it's weak in most of the stats. We are getting 2 bed of grass. Nice. We get 25 goop. And 26 XP. Okay. Awesome. Saving game, we can now have up to 8 beetles in our nest. We can now save up to 3 beetle appearances. Cool. Okay, blueberry. It is filled with antioxidants, whatever those are. Ooh, wooden block. Gazing or stacking fun for the swarm. A wooden building block laying on its side, kind of like a wall. A wooden building block standing tall, kind of like a door. Okay. Orange crystal cluster. A cluster of orange crystals to brighten up the nest. And... goop. Okay, awesome. So, let's see. I have about 50 seconds before these come home. How are we doing? Okay, I have to... okay, you kind of... Oh, look at that. I'm gonna go there and... rub against that. That's so cute. Hey, you! Oh, look at that. Playing with the... Aww, and then we're interacting with each other and socializing. Aren't they cute? Aww. And this little one was playing with that little rock there. Nice. Okay, so nest nice. Not so happy. You need healing. Okay, inventory. You can see it. Do I have any healing? Succeeded. Our nest Takiki successfully completed task for given harvest. Okay, so we got some hazelnut, we got some blueberry, we got some goop, and some more experience. Nice. Okay, but I don't know how... Oh, it was successfully completed task, flew around the nest, a new task was discovered, seeking sustenance. Okay, well, we got some experience, that is cool. And well rested. We got a bed of grass, bed of leaves, oop, and yeah. Okay, cool. Let's just pause here for a second. I don't think we have any healing items yet. Then we have all these interesting things. I guess I could kind of build little areas for them in the nest or what. I don't know what I would use these for. How did I turn this? Roll? No. Yeah, I've forgotten. How did we do this? Okay, it doesn't really matter. Scroll doesn't do it. I just turns that. Click this to place it where the beetles can use it. You can also double click to place or drag them out. Double click, yep. Items in the nest to relocate or rotate them. Okay, if I double click, I can rotate them, but how did I do that? If I double click, then I just place it, but how did I. I don't know. And how did I put you back? Okay, that didn't work. Okay, I don't remember how to do this. Let's just put that there. you do have some stuff to play around with over there. You could use some beds though. So let's just put a little bit over here for some... For some quiet time for someone there. And let's put a little bed of leaves maybe over here. And what else do we have? We have some food. A new beetle. Welcome your new beetle Naradi to the nest. Now Naradi is fine. Okay, you're not very good, but that's okay. We're gonna have a little baby beetle. And can't do that. Okay, well, let's start with this then. I feel like they're moving so fast, even on the slowest one. It's hard to keep up with what they need of food and things. Look at this little baby beetle over here. Nice. Okay. Well, it doesn't. Oh, there we go. I had to double click. Welcome your new beetle, Dasapor, to the nest. Okay, you're not very good either, but that's okay. We're gonna have a little baby beetle too. Let's just go back to our nest. Oh, beetle view. There we go. Let's see. Someone needs healing. Food, fun, rest, and grooming to be happy. Well, they can groom, they can have fun, and we need rest. Let's just make another bed over there. Let's make a little grass bed right there. And we have a rope, we have something to play with. Let's put a little block over here for someone to play with, and that should help heal them all up. Nice, what do you do? Decoration item. Ah, there we go. These items are for decorating the nest. They don't contribute to beetle happiness value. Really, they are for you. Oh, okay. Let's put a little over there. Oh. There we go. Okay, nice. So hopefully now they should start healing up. Some of them are hungry. Okay, that makes sense. Pumpkin seed. Put a pumpkin seed there. Let's put a pumpkin seed there. Let's take a little blueberry. Nice. And maybe someone wants some sugar too. Cool. How are we doing? Grooming. Well, they do have this one they can groom on, so that should be fine. Now they are getting happy. Nesna is getting there. Naradi is getting there. Dasapo is getting there. Everybody needs grooming. Oh, they already used this up. Well, put a new one in there, then you'll go and sleep again. Awesome. Give me some experience. Cool. There we go. Cool. Nice. You're growing up. That is cool. Whoop. Okay, more hungry. Wow, they eat so much. It's ridiculous. Where did you come from? Oh, sorry about that, guys. I have a little... Oh, what was that? I have no idea. Okay, how are we doing now? Oh, really happy. Really happy. Awesome. Okay. So far, so good. Wow, we are getting a little bit done today. Okay, we have a new... a quest up here, but we got some quests done. That is cool. Very nice. Okay, so what do we have we can do? We can breed. We have our map. We have some quests here. Awesome. Options. Okay. Well, we could try and do some breeding. Who would we want to breed, I'm thinking? The Kiki kind of have some nice high stats. Or has the highest and some medium stats. You're kind of low, you're low. You're kind of low there. You do have higher on this. Well, this one would be... These two would be nice if I could get the A, S, and Q over on. And then the other ones here. So maybe we should go this one. Say Ootsie. Okay, you two. For the combination, we might be able to get a nice combination of these. Click to breed. Okay, let's see what we get. Did we get anything valuable? Wow, you have a gorgeous color, but it's completely medium. Okay, here we got some higher ones there. But high. I'm kind of thinking this one. There's like 5 out of them, and we actually got the high ones on these ones, plus a high one there and a high one there. So we kind of, I think this is the best combination of them. Yeah, let's go with you. Yep. Okay, watch pack. Yep. Okay, let's do that. Okay, now we can't breed anymore. Either you cannot have more beetles at your current level, or you don't have enough goop to pay to... Well, I don't think I can have any more beetles. So I think... Oh, no, I didn't mean to do that. Let's go back to our nest. There we go. Someone came. Awesome. Now we have a new little baby. So I think we are going to have to choose to turn someone into goop. I am kind of looking at Dasapo, one of our new ones, though, because you have 3 red ones and white. Not very handy. And the same for Unaquil over here. They have, like, bad stats all around. So, if I take Dasapo, did I turn you into... Use the selected beetle. This destroys the beetle and recovers some goop. Do you really want to use... Permanently destroy this beetle, you'll gain 56 scoop in exchange. I feel kind of bad about this, but yes. Ooh, hi baby. And unicorn. I am sorry. Yep. Yep. Okay, so that should give us some extra slots. So we have two extra slots. What does it take to unlock this? I don't know. See, we still have our little rats pack baby here. Okay, that of course changed. Oh yeah, now I have to get used to that, because now these are like, they have the red core stats. The rats pack might be someone I would want to breed with someone else, like for instance with Takiki. That's a little strange, but okay. Because then we would get Q, H, and A, and R and P, for instance. That could be nice if we could get a combination there. It is a little confusing with this breeding them. But there's also the colors you could go for. Like, I really like, for instance, Naradi's color. We go here. Look at that, Naradi. But how did I do that? Because I know I can store the color, but how do I do that? I know I can do it once I have bred them. But how do I do it in here? Oh, I have to do it like this, right? Look at this. Naradi, you look really gorgeous. Then we have Deeros, we have Nesna, we have our little rat pack here. And there we go. Oh, that's right, that's how we did it. Look at that. And alrighty. I like these colors. And the horns on the back, that is cool. I do like these colors too, actually. Let's see. Ooh. Look at the texture, that is actually different here. Is that cool? Takiki. Did you get that too? What's back? Yeah, it looks like you did. Okay. And we have this one. So we have these colors that I have stored. This must be someone that I gooped, because we don't have that color now. Or is that Tiro's color? I think that's actually Tiro's color. And we have this fancy green one. Okay, but I want to... Let's store you. Cancel. How do I... Oh, there we go. Store. So otherwise I replace these ones. But now we have three different colors. I am not sure how that works if I want to change the color of someone else. But yeah. Let's just try. If we say Nesna, for instance. And we say... this one, for instance. Apply. We want to apply this look to the selected beetle. Does it cost something? We have 2468. Okay, now Nesna looks like that one. Okay. Interesting. That's kind of easy to change the look of them. So we don't really have to breed for that. We just have to kind of save the colors before we move on. Of course, we have to unlock enough to be able to save the looks for them, but that's kind of cool. Okay, well, I think that was it for today, guys. That was just, we got some exploration done and some combat. That was cool. Nice. Yes, you need to go and sleep. Let's just pause this. There we go. And yeah, I don't know. Maybe I'll do another video of this. We'll have to see when I get a little bit further along. Yeah, now you got to see a little bit of the questing. There we go, look at that. Nice, we have more stuff we need to do. But yeah, I might do another video when I have kind of moved out to this area. You can see I've actually unlocked something there, so we can go and explore. So we might do one more video to see if I can come out and see some of the other areas. But yeah, thank you for watching, and as always, do take care and happy gaming!